Grasshopper Dissection. After completing this video, you should be able to 1. Name the organs of the grasshopper. 2. Identify the features that serve as adaptations for grasshoppers living in terrestrial habitats. And 3. Demonstrate the correct procedure for dissecting a grasshopper. To complete this lab, you'll need the following materials: personal protective equipment, dissection tools and pan, grasshopper specimen, and a camera for documenting your work. Before you begin, place a small but legible piece of paper with your name and the date of the dissection to be included with any images taken of your specimen. Observe the external anatomy of your grasshopper as described in the arthropod learning unit that accompanies this lab. Locate the head, thorax, and abdomen. See if you can determine whether your specimen is a male or female. Then observe the legs, wings, spiracles, eyes, and mouth of your grasshopper. Begin the dissection by using scissors to cut up the dorsal side of the exoskeleton. Do this from the tip of the abdomen all the way to the head. Make sure your cuts are shallow so as not to cut into internal organs. Hold the scissors parallel to the dissecting pan to cut. Hold the exoskeleton up and cut just underneath it with the point of the scissors. Gently remove the dorsal wall of the exoskeleton. Observe any segmentation patterns found within the grasshopper. Tracheal tubes appear as fibers extending from the body of the grasshopper to the exoskeleton. These are air tubes used in respiration and function to exchange gases between tissues and the surrounding air. The tracheal tubes connect to the outside via the spiracles. Take an image and label the tracheal tubes. The large, conspicuous structure that fills most of the thoracic region is the crop. The crop stores food temporarily. Take a picture and label the crop. Anterior to the crop is the esophagus. Posterior to the crop is the stomach. This is where digestion takes place. Small molecules are absorbed into the bloodstream after passing through the walls of the stomach. Take a picture and label the stomach. Connected to the digestive tract between the crop and the stomach are pouch-like structures called gastric ceca that excrete digestive enzymes, breaking down food and helping with its absorption. There should be several pairs of these finger-like extensions. Just posterior to the stomach and anterior to the large intestine are the tiny tubules that make up the excretory system, called the Malpighian tubules. These structures function in a similar fashion to kidneys by removing metabolic waste. Eventually, the metabolic waste from the ileum is transported to the anterior end of the large intestine and removed with digestive wastes. Take a picture and label the Malpighian tubes. Next, observe the intestine. The intestine transports waste out of the body. In conclusion, you should have learned that the grasshopper displays bilateral symmetry and has a high degree of cephalization with its specialized mouthparts and sensory structures. Moreover, the grasshopper is well adapted for life in a terrestrial environment with its exoskeleton, jointed appendages, wings, and respiratory organs such as its spiracles and tracheae.